This video is all about do's and don'ts after the embryo transfer. Embryo transfer is the most important step of an IVF treatment. And when the big day arrives, it's quite an event. This 2-week wait is indeed an emotional roller coaster for the patients, and it is quite natural for them to get anxious and nervous. One of the commonest questions asked to us is, "Doctor, what are the do's and don'ts after the embryo transfer?" As they are very worried about the risk of failure and are petrified that they might end up doing something which might cause the embryos to fall out of the uterus. Now, through this video, I would like to address some of the do's and don'ts after the embryo transfer in a more scientific way. And as we go along, I hope certain common myths surrounding the post-embryo transfer care get addressed. Beginning with the do's. Do take your hormonal medications at the prescribed time and in the prescribed dose by the fertility specialist until the date of your blood test. You can resume your normal activities and even go back to work, provided it is not a physically demanding job. Do have a healthy, balanced diet with high protein intake and avoid any kind of processed, oily and spicy foods. Drink plenty of fluids, as fluid not only helps in maintaining the cell hydration but also its proper functioning, be it endometrial cells. And most importantly, relax, not just your body but your mind. Try to maintain a calm and positive outlook and surround yourself with people who make you more happy and relaxed. Coming to the don'ts. So do not use hot tubs and saunas and avoid hot baths, as keeping the body temperature to a normal level is advisable, as it might not be ideal for the embryo implantation. Also, avoid any kind of strenuous physical activities which involves heavy weight lifting, cycling, jogging, running, etc. But you can, however, continue with your moderate activities like walking, cooking and driving. Do not go for complete bed rest, as it has been scientifically proven that bed rest cannot increase the success rates after IVF. In fact, bed rest can be even counterproductive and create a lot of stress, as sitting whole day without work can be very demoralizing. And believe me, this kind of stress cannot be good for you. Also, avoid sexual intercourse within the days between your embryo transfer and the pregnancy results. Avoid alcohol consumption, cigarette smoking, and limit your caffeine intake. And most importantly, do not panic. A critical piece of advice that I would like to give my patients is, do not panic. Whether embryo implants or not is a biological process, and there is nothing that the patients can do to influence this in any way. It is very important to understand that the embryo implantation is not in your hands, and it is very important that you do not blame yourself in case the outcome of the cycle does not turn out to be successful. All you can do is gracefully let the nature take its own course. Thank you.